everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to see one important topic, that is the fixed end moment. Fixed end moment are useful for the slope deflection method, moment distribution method, as well as it is asked directly in some state level competitive exams, that they give you the different kind of a loading and asked you to find the correct fixed end moment, and they will give you four options. You have to choose the right option. Okay, so we will see all of them one by one, and we will see the different kind of a loading and the fixed end moment for it. Okay, so the first case is, this is a fixed beam which is fixed at both the ends, and if we apply the load, that is W load or P load, it may be any load, at a span L by 2 means at the central position. Okay, if this is A, this is B, and this point is C, it is the central portion of this beam. Okay, so if this load is applied on it, so there will be a moment due to the fixed support. Okay, so this moment will be anti-clockwise at this end and the clockwise at this end. Okay, so this is represented by the M bar AB. Fixed end moment is represented by M bar. Okay, and for this, this will be represented by M bar BA. Okay, so we will write the value of a fixed end moment for this joint and for this joint. Okay, at this joint the moment, fixed end moment will be negative because it is anti-clockwise, and at this joint it is clockwise, so it on this joint the fixed end moment will be positive. Okay, so for this case the value of a fixed end moment at the A joint is equals to minus WL by 8. Okay, what is W? W is the applied loading. What is L? L is the total span of this beam. Okay, this is the total span of the beam and divided by 8. Okay, so this is clock anti-clockwise, that's why I have put the sign minus here. And for the joint B, it is WL by 8, but it is positive due to the clockwise moment. This is our first case. Okay, this is the first type of a case in which the loading is applied at the central portion. But we will see the second case. What if the loading does not apply on the central portion, rather than it is applied on the anywhere of the beam? Okay, so if this is the span A and this is the span B, and total length is of the beam is L. Okay, this is joint A and this is joint B. So the moment will develop here is the anti-clockwise moment, and here it will develop clockwise moment. Okay, so the value for this will be equals to WAB square by L square, and it is anti-clockwise, that why we will put the minus sign here. Okay, and for this joint it will be equals to WA square B by L square. Remember one thing, that for this joint, if you are considering for this joint, you will take the square of B here, but if you consider for this joint, you will take the square of A. Okay, so don't get confused, it is WAB square by L square, it is WA square B by L square. Okay, next we will see the third case. Our third case is that if the UDL is applied on a fixed beam and its value is, UDL value is W kilonewton per meter. Okay, so if this UDL is applied on the fixed beam, then what will be the fixed end moment? Okay, so due to this UDL, the fixed end moment developed will be M bar AB here and M bar BA here. Okay, so this is the any span L, so its value will be equals to minus WL square by 12. Minus WL square by 12 due to the anti-clockwise moment here, and positive WL square by 12 due to the clockwise moment here. Okay, so this is our third case. Next we will see our fourth case, that when the UVL, this is the UVL load applied on the fixed beam, then in that case we will find the fixed end moment. Okay, so if this is the loading that is applied on the fixed beam, so moment developed here will be equals to M bar AB in the anti-clockwise direction, and here it will develop in the clockwise direction. So the value of a fixed end moment for the joint A will be equals to minus 5 upon 96 WL square. Okay, and here similarly for here it will be equals to WL square by 96. This should be the positive value. Okay, so this is our fourth case. Next we will see our fifth case, that is when this kind of a UDL is applied in the fixed beam, then what should be the fixed end moment. So if this kind of a loading, that is a uniformly varying and uniformly increasing load, is applied on this beam, then in that case the value of a fixed end moment at the point A will be equals to WL square by 30, and it is negative because of the anticlockwise moment at A. And the value of a fixed end moment for the joint B will be equals to WL square by 20. So these values are not same, as you can see that the loading is also a varying load and it is not same for the both the joints. So that's why at the joint A the moment will be less and at the joint B the moment will be more. Okay, next we will see when this is applied all over the span L. But if this kind of a loading is applied at the half span, that is L by 2, then what should be the fixed end moment? So in this case the fixed end moment at the joint A will be equals to minus 7 upon 960 WL square. This is the value of a fixed end moment at the joint A. And for the joint B, the value of a fixed end moment will be equals to 23 WL square by 960. Remember, 960 is common in both these formula. Just you have to remember that here it is minus 7, here it is positive 23. Next we will see, these are the cases, different cases of loading on the fixed beam. Next we will see the effect of a moment on the fixed beam and how it contribute to the fixed end moment. Okay, so if this is the beam, this is the fixed beam, and if this moment of magnitude M is applied on it at a span L by 2 and L by 2. Okay, means at the central position. Okay, so if this is the moment, that is clockwise moment is applied on the fixed beam, in that case the whole beam will try to move in the clockwise direction. For example, this is any beam, and if the moment or the clockwise moment is applied at the central position in this way, and if this is try to rotate the beam in the clockwise direction only. Okay, so the whole beam will move clockwise, so the moment developed will be clockwise at both the ends. Both the ends the moment developed will be clockwise. So in that case the value of moment will be equals to M by 4 and M by 4. This is our seventh case. Next we will see our eighth case, that is when the moment is applied at the span L by 2 and L by 2 in the anti-clockwise direction. So this whole beam will try to move in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so moment will develop anti-clockwise at both the end A and the end B. So here the value of a moment, fixed end moment for the joint A and for the joint B will be equals to minus M by 4 and the minus M by 4. Okay, so this is our eighth case. Next we will see our ninth case, that is if the moment is applied somewhere at the beam, span of the beam. For example, this is a span A and this is length B and the whole span is of length L. In that case at both the end the moment developed will be and will be clockwise only. Okay, so here at both the end the moment developed will be clockwise. So in that case the value of a fixed end moment will be equals to MB into 2A minus B upon L square, and for joint B it will be equals to MA 2B minus A to the L square. Okay, divided by L square. These are the value of a fixed end moment in the case when the moment is not at the central position, rather than it is at a somewhere at the span of the beam. So this is our ninth case. The next two cases, that is the 10th case and 11th case, are due to the effect of a sinking. So if this is the any fixed beam and the B joint is sinked to the displacement del, value of a fixed end moment, the value of a fixed end moment at the joint A will be equals to 6 EI del by L square. Okay, and similarly for the joint B it is also equals to 6 EI del by L square, because the moment at both the joint is the anti-clockwise. Okay, but if this support is sinking in this way, it is moving downward, then in that case the moment developed here and here will be clockwise. Okay, so that's why the fixed end moment in this case will be equals to 6 EI del upon L square, and here also it is 6 EI del upon L square. So remember, for the clockwise movement the value is positive, and for the anti-clockwise movement at the joints the value should be negative. Okay. These two cases are very important. So these are the different cases that is helpful for you to solve the slope deflection equation and the moment distribution method, and it is generally asked directly in some state level exams. So hope you have enjoyed this lecture. In the next lecture we will see the standard results of a slope deflection method that are also very important for the competitive exam. If this video is helpful to you, then like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.